can do. You disappoint me, Martin.
Why don't you come down and settle this man to man?
The view is nice up here. I'm not moving.
Don't try to act brave, you worthless piece of inbred shit.
Come and get me if you're so strong.
Stupid blue blood. Let's see how you like this.
Martin, you couldn't hit me if I was standing next to you.
Now I'll sit for a while and consider the problem of getting into the gatehouse. I need time alone.
What now?
Go!
I'd say goodbye to my kids.
But I didn't know.
I thought we had already won.
I still say his lordship was right to try for the girl. The admiral was just faster.
His lordship...
might be worth
it.
Here to add me to your list?
Corvo, I knew you would get here. Well, you're too late. I'm already dying without your help. A stray bullet. I'll never know whose. What could I offer you anyway? You want money? Well, I'm broke. Women, maybe? Everyone knows you were screwing the Empress. You like noble women. You should meet my cousin Celia. At least I outlive Martin. Good breeding always rises above.
They picked the wrong side of this fight.
I can't even tell who's on the...
Squad. What happened last night? Indeed, I believe so.
done such things, cowardly things, and I'm ashamed of. How could anyone ever forgive us? Would they? Even if things are better?
Let me go!
No, no,
quiet!
That's not how it works.
Move
once the
already,
bureaucrats step in, everything gets worse.
Another bloody mess you've left behind. You two want your honor back? To rescue the lady in distress? Oh no, Corvo. That's not you.
I don't know about you, Corvo, but I've had a lovely time. Intrigue and mystery, butchery and betrayal, the death throes of an empire. And you were an avenging spirit, spreading chaos at every turn. The city's feeding on itself now, liars and merchants and nobles like maggots on a carcass. Soon will be nothing left for the rats. It's just as well. The Empire was dying already, completely rotten. All that was needed was the right man to send it over the edge. But now, you'll be off over the horizon on an outbound ship. I wonder, are you chasing something or running away?
Dead, aren't they? That's all right, because I was going to have them killed anyway. I am going to be Empress.
What will history tell us? That the daughter of a murdered empress ascended the throne up a mountain of corpses? Carried by an assassin named Corvo? No. They'll say that little Emily Caldwin I came to power in an age of terror and corruption, and that she did her best in a world that is not kind to little girls or empresses. Whether the stories told mention you by name or not, she will remember you were there, Corvo.
Talents wasted until he found his fate. Callisto, the nurse, bitter PM, ejected from the academy. Samuel, the useless old, hungry for bullish. Couldn't be with us today. This is all Martin's fault. We hadn't helped Corvo get out of prison. Corvo hadn't been so damn good at his job. We hadn't gotten greedy and afraid. If. Always too sure that was my problem. Never hesitated. Too sure of what I wanted. Too sure of what I wanted to do when other men stopped to consider. Saw it as a weakness. I know Corvo's coming for me just like he came for the others. Crossing the island below like it was nothing. It's only a question of how and when. But I'm lacking a countermove. It's all fallen apart. All the stuff that led us here makes sense. When I was young, I went to sea. Took command of a ship and made aimless men into sailors. Made a collection of boats into a navy. Then founded a conspiracy and almost led an empire. No compromise. Never showed mercy. Never showed weakness. And I showed the world what mattered. Will and vision. And not being afraid of getting dirty. And now, I'll lose it all to a man with a faster sword hand. Or is it that he has a slower sword hand? There's something wrong with the world. It'll make a good story for the history. I'll have a good epitaph. In his time, he commanded a noble lord, a high overseer. The man who brought down a titan, Admiral Havelock, son of the high ocean. Did you think I'd fight you, Corvo? Sorry to disappoint. This is yours. The key to Emily's cell. She'll be glad to see you. You made quite an impression on her. Did you know that? She asked about you constantly. Where you were. What you'd been doing. I told her. In the end, I told her everything. From the start, when we had such noble goals in mind. To the end, when we were afraid, fighting in secrecy about who we could trust and who we had to kill. Arguing over who would act as new Lord Regent. And she listened, eyes wide. She's become an interesting girl. If she lives, she'll make a memorable entrance. Wait, who is that? Everyone get over here!
Thank you.
such things. Cowardly things, and I'm ashamed of. How could anyone ever forgive us? Would they? Even if things are better? No, no, that's not how it works. Once the bureaucrats step in, everything gets muddy. If anyone ever knew, we'd all lose our heads for this. So no one can know. And could we ever control Emily with Corvo around? That's the question that sticks in my mind. We need to make our final move, and we need to make it cleanly. No loose ends. Only a few in the know. The ones with the most to lose.
Is it going to be okay now? Will I be Empress?
So ends the interregnum, and now Emily Caldwin I will take her mother's throne after a season of turmoil. You will stand at her side, Corvo, guiding her young mind and protecting her from those who seek to exploit her or cause her harm. You watched and listened when other men would have shouted in rage. You held back instead of striking. So it is with the passing of the plague and Emily's ascension, comes a golden age brought about by your hand. And decades hence, when your hair turns white and you pass from this world, Empress Emily, Emily the Wise, at the height of her power, will lay your body down within her mother's great tomb, because you are more to her than a royal protector. Farewell, Corvo.
Oh, I long for all of the big and the small, where the taller they stand, where the harder they fall. We live for today, but we die for the next. With blood in our veins, in the air, in our chest, or we step into war with our hearts on the line. The dirt on our boots, it shakes free over time. It's a distant aroma at best, a withering smile that's stuck deep in your vest. The night air, it wraps its fingers around your body, it shakes from a now distant sound. Oh, the sound of her voice, a sweet symphony, played over and over until you are free. Yeah. standing tall. Well, death it will come, as sure as the night. But we will not run, no, we live but to fight. Oh, with blood on our hands and dirt on our knees, we tear after once we brought the disease.
Climbing up the east.